One of the most important electrochemical cell is nickel cadmium storage cell, which is probably called NiCad cell. The word NiCad is coming from the fact that Ni is for nickel and CAD is for cadmium. So here the overall equation of nickel cadmium storage cell is given in the slide. So you also need to know what are the reactions, split reactions of cathode and anode, and if you add the half equations of anode, which is oxidation half reaction, and the reduction half reaction of cathode, how you will get the overall equation. Okay, apart from this, first let me give some details about this NiCad cell. So we are here discussing about NiCad cell. N is for nickel and CAD is for cadmium. This is how you will remember the cells, NiCad cell. So the first point is, this is a once again a rechargeable cell, means it is a primary cell. I'm sorry, it's a secondary cell. It's a secondary rechargeable means it's a secondary cell. Kindly excuse me. It is not rechargeable, it's primary. And this is used most popularly in calculators or watches and etc. It possesses a much longer life, battery life is much longer than even lead storage battery. Next, what is its construction? The construction is anode will be cadmium electrode What is the cathode? Cathode is metal grid containing nickel 4 oxide and electrolyte is aqueous KOH. Now going to the equations. So what happens at anode? Always at anode oxidation takes place. That is, cadmium in the electrolytic solution reacts with OH minus to form cadmium hydroxide. So all of you know cadmium metals, I did not write, this is cadmium 2 hydroxide. So therefore here 0 to plus 2 oxidation state, so this is oxidation. So here once again you have to write plus 2 electrons, no? Charge should be balanced. So to balance this equation, 2 OH minus is there, you can put 2 here and the equation is supposed to be balanced. Okay, great. Now let us go to say the next one is cathode. reaction at cathode's reduction. So here nickel 4 oxide, as I already given in the previous explanation, nickel 4 oxide is available at cathode, and it is immersed in the aqueous medium. You see the explanation what I given. Metal cathode is a metal grid containing nickel 4 oxide. It is introduced in aqueous medium, aqueous KOH. So always in reduction, electrons will come on the right hand side, left hand side. Here also you will get nickel hydroxide plus OH minus ions. Now to balance this equation, once again we'll put 2H2O here, and two negative charges, one negative charge on the right hand side. So here also 2 will come to balance hydrogen, 2 into 2, 4, 2 plus 2, 4. So the electrons also 2, it will come. Now, so you can, I think you can write this molecules, nickel 2 hydroxide is this one, I'm not writing, you write it. Now you cancel the common terms. What are the common terms, just check it out. 2 OH minus cancelled. Then 2 electrons cancelled. So therefore, what is the final equation? If you add up this, you will get it. So therefore, cadmium solid plus 2 OH minus 2 OH minus cancelled, 2 electron cancelled. Therefore, plus NiO2 plus 2H2O giving you cadmium hydroxide plus 2 OH minus. Shall we see, children? This is called systematic way of learning. Without byhearting the equations, you should know what is a anode, what is a cathode, and it is in the basic medium. You should try to write the ion electron. This is ion electron method, ion electron equation method. If you write and cancel the common terms, you are getting the final equation.